Hi all, welcome back to this screencast. In the last video we saw how to add a new task in our task list. In this video we'll be enabling markdown support for our task contents. So what is markdown? Markdown is a very simplistic text formatting language, and GitHub has its own markdown flavor, and we'll be using GitHub flavored markdown. You can Google it up, to Google the syntax of markdown and GitHub flavored markdown. There are a lot of resources available to learn the syntax. The reason why we are adding the support of markdown to our task manager is, since it is a formatting tool, it is extremely powerful when it comes to formatting stuff. And we have ready-made packages available to convert that markdown text into HTML. And once we add markdown support, our app becomes extremely powerful. So this is the views.go file in the views package. So first thing we'll do is we import the GitHub flavored markdown library. We first have to go get it if it is not present in our system. It is written by the user Sherkool. And what it does is it takes input. So what I do now is I have the tasks array, a global array, and I loop in that array and I do this. So tasks of I dot content is the content of my task. I first convert it into a byte, an array of byte, and then I call the markdown function of it. Okay, and then what I have to do is I have to first create a new element called as HTML content of the type template.html. The reason why we have to go to importing text HTML template and creating another variable inside our task struct is because by default the Go programming language will you give an, in the last video itself we saw, when I gave some JavaScript and HTML input, it was interpreted literally. So what happens is when you give a markdown, say this is for bold in markdown and this is for italic, any word which is prepended and appended by underscore is italic, and which is prepended and appended by double star is bold. So when my text is this and I use md.markdown function, then what it will do is it basically converts that into HTML, and then we inject this HTML inside our Go template. So the problem becomes when I have a markdown syntax, it won't inject the HTML, it will insert the HTML in such a way that I'll get the literal HTML in the output on my screen. Yes, as we saw in the last video. So what I have to do is I have to use this special data type, which is HTML template.html, which is only to be used when we implicitly trust the user to do the right thing. So here what we are doing is we are not allowing the user to type in HTML. What we are doing is we take the markdown input and we compute the HTML, and only that HTML goes into HTML content. Now this template.html is nothing but a struct definition, type definition of a basic string. So what we need to do is, instead of this string, we need to convert that string into template.html. Then what will happen is we get So for each task we add, we are going to create a new element and append to it the HTML content of my markdown syntax. So I'll save this file. Okay, so here only one change we need to do is instead of value.content, we have to do value.html content. So I'll just, for the sake of demonstration, so now what we can get is we have bold text, we have italic text, and we have checkboxes. This checkboxes is a feature of GitHub flavored markdown. One more nice stuff that this will do is, we'll see, this will be the last one. So three backticks and say Python. So see, then here we can see that the code got converted into Python syntax. So I'm not sure why we are not seeing colors over here. Usually on GitHub flavor markdown we also get syntax highlighting, and that is why we need to use the triple back quotes. So GitHub flavored markdown is extremely powerful because of this subtask feature. So say I have a very big project, so I am using this task manager to manage this screencast creation. So what I have done in my private instance is I have created a activity here, and I have each video I have as a subtask, and after completing I just complete it. Here I have to edit the task, so I can then understand what my status is accordingly, and then I can give more preference to one task and something like that. So it is a very powerful and neat feature to have in any task management application. So this was about markdown conversion, and we also randomly print the markdown content and later the HTML in our code. So let me just delete that. That is on line number 68. Cool, so we have that done. So the next time I'll run this after building the binary, I won't get this printed on my console, which is unnecessary. So this was about adding markdown control, and in the next video we are going to connect finally to the database, and we have about 2 or 3 videos left in which will perform the same operations like add task, delete task, complete task on the database. As of now, what we were doing is we are storing a global variable tasks, and we keep on appending to that variable itself. So starting from the next video, we'll be storing all those tasks inside the database, and every refresh will happen as a fetch from the database. Okay, so thank you for watching this video, and please stay tuned for the next one.